Hello dear students, Assalamu alaikum. Welcome you all to our online video class. I hope by the grace of Almighty Allah, all of you are doing well. With you, this is me, Shahnaz Parveen, lecturer, Department of Biology, Milestone College, Uttara, Dhaka. You have already finished chapter 9. Today, in front of you, I will represent a new topic from chapter 10. I hope all of you enjoyed today's class. So let's start. Chapter 10, Reproduction of Plants. Topic is Development of Male Gametophyte. From this topic, we have to learn definition of reproduction, different flower parts, structure of pollen grain, and male gametophyte development process. Learning outcome. Development method of male gametophyte in angiospermic plant. Dear students, all organisms die after a certain period of time. That's why offspring are the indicator of an organism existence. Reproduction is a mandatory event for all living organisms to maintain their existence on the earth. Every organism produces self-like offspring. So, what is reproduction? Reproduction is a physiological process through which an organism produces similar offsprings. It is a unique characteristic of living organism which is absent in non-living things. Why reproduction is important? It conserves the heredity and existence of species. It facilitates propagation and proliferation of species. It maintains environmental balance. Sexual reproduction accumulates different characteristics of a species, which helps in the evolution of the organism, create genetic diversity. There are two types of reproduction are observed in plants. One is sexual reproduction and another is asexual reproduction. Flower is a special reproductive organ of angiosperms, which is a completely modified shoot specially adapted for sexual reproduction. In this slide, you can see the common flower parts. At first, we have to learn about the part of flower. The outermost hole is called sepal. Next hole is called petal, which is colorful and attractive. It helps to attract insect to pollination. Anther and filament make the stamen, which is male reproductive part of the flower. Stigma, style, and ovary are the female reproductive part, which is known as pistil. The development of male gametophyte consists of following steps: development of microsporangium, structure of pollen grain, and development of male gametophyte. In this slide, you can see the flower parts, stamen, which is male reproductive part. Androecium is the third hole of a flower, and member of this hole are called stamen. The basal part of each stamen is stalk-like. It is called filament. The upper part of a stamen is like sac, which produces pollen grain. This sac-like portion is called anther. Each anther contain four pollen sac. It is also called microsporangia,
and each pollen sac consists of 5 to 7 layer, which is sterile. The outermost layer is called epidermis. The second layer is called endodermis. After endodermis, the next layer is called middle layer or middle lamella. The innermost layer is called tapetum. This tapetum layer melts down and acts as a nutrition source. Converted by the tapetum layer, some cells relatively large, arranged in a circular manner. This type of cell is sporogenous tissue or microspore mother cell, which is diploid. Each cell produces haploid pollen grain by meiosis division. In this slide, you can see the pollen grain produced from a pollen mother cell by meiosis cell division. This is pollen mother cell which is diploid. Meiosis cell division, it produces 2 cells. Again, meiosis division occurs and produces 4 cell, which is haploid. And this haploid cell stay together, which is called pollen tetrad, and all are haploid. It becomes separated from each other and arranged in different manner. This is called pollen grain and haploid. So we learn how pollen grain formed from by pollen mother cell. In this slide you can see the structure of pollen grain. It's a microscopic view. This is pollen grain. The outermost layer is called exine. This layer is called intine. This is nucleus. And this pore-like structure is called germ pore. So, pollen grain is unicellular, uninucleate, haploid, and spherical or oval-shaped structure. It is with double layered wall called sporoderm. The outer layer of pollen wall is thick, highly resistant, is called exine. It may be spiny in insect pollinated plant. Exine is mainly composed of a complex substance called sporopollenin. The inner layer is thin and delicate, is called intine. It is composed of cellulose. Exine is interrupted at one or more places which look like small pores, is called germ pore. Pollen grain is the initial cell of male gametophyte.
Now we will learn how male gametophyte developed in angiospermic plant. You know, pollen grain is the initial cell of male gametophyte. After release from the anther, pollen grain start to germinate. Now we start to draw pollen grain. Dear students, start draw with me. have already learned about pollen grain. This is pollen grain. And haploid. This is germ pore. At first, two uneven nuclei are formed through mitosis cell division. The larger one is called tube nucleus and the smaller one is generative nucleus. Usually, pollen grain released in this binucleate state and reach to the stigma as the same flower or another flower of same species in the process of pollination. Further development of pollen grain occurs in stigma. The secretion from stigma excites pollen grain and the intern layer of pollen grain grow and come through the germ pore, which is called pollen tubes. The tube nucleus located at the tip of the pollen tube and generative nucleus stay behind it. This is tube nucleus. And this is pollen tube. This is generative nucleus. This is tube nucleus and this is pollen tube. Pollen tube move towards the ovary, penetrating through the stigma. During this period, generative nucleus divided into two. Generative nucleus divided into two nucleus through mitosis cell division, and this is called male gamete. This is called male gamete. Pollen tube, male gamete, tube nucleus all together is called male gametophyte. And this is the process of male gametophyte development in angiospermic plant. So hope all of you enjoyed today's lecture. If you have any question, ask your subjective teacher.
In this slide you can see some questions. You have to learn this question, such as what is reproduction, or what is pollen tetrad, or what is pollinium. What do you mean pollination? Describe the growth and development of male gametophyte. And for your higher ability, explain the importance of the male gamete in the production of fruit and seed. Now I want to give you a homework. Describe the development of male gametophyte with figure.
For today, that's all from my side. Thank you so much for being with me. Stay home, stay safe, and save a life. Allah Hafiz.